Sunday the 22nd of May 2016. I'm at the National Trust Sheringham Park, Norfolk. And today's walk's an unusual one because I'm going to film what would be my work journey from here to Cromer, which entails mainly road walking, albeit that they're quiet backwaters. It's about 9 miles. Weather today is grey, quite mild though, bit of a breeze but nothing to worry about, and no rain forecast luckily. So as I say, this walk isn't one of my typical ones, but I'm doing a couple of days work here a week and I'm thinking of getting a bike and cycling the 9 miles here and back. So let's see what the journey looks like. That van over there, that French van, is one of the potential workplaces. Opens up usually for teas and coffees and what have you. Not today though, which is interesting. And it's quite busy from what I've seen. Now the reason why it's busy at the moment, and indeed it's probably the busiest time of the year for Sheringham Park, is because of this display, or its display, of azaleas and rhododendrons. So they weren't quite out last week when I was here last, but they could well be now. I won't bother getting a shot of those today, but what I'll do is I'll come back in the middle of the week when it's quieter, after I've done a few hours work, and film them then. Get up in one of the towers and you look down on top of them, so that way we'll get a better view, and I'll put that on the end of this film. As you can see from these buds here, not quite ready, so I think if I leave it a few days till next week, we'll have a full display. One thing you might also pick up from this commentary, apart from my voice, is the plethora of birdsong in this place. You get an amazing array of birds in here, it's wonderful. It's like working in an aviary. Blackcaps, nuthatches, firecrests have been seen apparently, although I question that, probably a goldcrest got mixed up. Well, there we go. A very popular dog walking park for locals. That lodge keeper's got a great place to live. Wonderful premises. Having said that though, we've got the very busy A148 immediately behind me, which I've got across. And the local bus stop is just there, off where those bikes are. You have been warned. I heard that a young girl was killed crossing this very point recently, getting off the bus, trying to walk down the lane. I'm about to walk down over there into West Beckham. A couple of hundred yards in, away from the busy A148, and we enter the village of West Beckham. No relation to David, thank God. Public footpath just over there on my left. Past the village green, which must be down a path down there somewhere. Note the may blossom out now, which indicates we should be warm enough to cast a clout. Lovely smell. Can't believe it's the middle of May already. Obviously, not walking on a regular basis, I'm missing out on all of this. My favourite time of year, as I continually say. Lovely blue flower there. Don't know if that's a native or I'd say it is. Perhaps somebody could tell us what that is. Because I don't know. Wonderful. Obviously the bluebells are on their way out. Kind of missed that really. But what we get plenty of instead of bluebells are buttercups and cow parsley. Yeah, and pheasants. Now entering the village of West Beckham. Classic arable country around here. Road surface is fine thus far, thinking in terms of the bike. Cow parsley everywhere. Wonderful at this time of year. Chestnut in bloom. Underneath a spreading chestnut tree. Okay, little inscription here on the village sign telling us that it was erected in 1984, etc, etc. Been re-erected twice, as you can read, in 98 and 2000. Passing the wheat sheaf, West Beckham. Typical brick and flint building, although it doesn't look like it's open at the minute. It's about 3:30 Sunday afternoon, having started around 3 o'clock. St Helen and All Saints, West Beckham. Omnipresent chiff chaff in the background. And for once I've actually found it. Not often they reveal themselves like that. What a wonderful little chapel this is. Probably a service here this morning. Very plain. No, well, even the lead glass windows are plain. Nice vaulted ceiling. Looking back. What a wonderful country lane this is. Multitude of flowers here. Again, a lovely little blue one. Not sure what that is. It's like... Nope, I don't think that's forget-me-not. And this pinky one. Lovely. This would certainly make pleasant cycling. Few English bluebells drooping there on the right side of the bend, interestingly, facing north, I think. Whereas on the other side of the bend, none at all. The hedge is a classic English hedge as well. Looks like a bit of hornbeam or beech in there. Slow. Well cut as well. Broad at the bottom, narrow to the top. Doesn't look like it's been thrashed by a machine. some gorse in it. Scots pine plantation on my left. Classic territory for crossbills, which apparently are up here. Having reached this junction, the route I had marked out on the map was actually left to East Beckham. But what I'm going to do is walk down this way to East Beckham and see if it's passable for a bike, because it's marked as a track on the map, even though the sign is for a public footpath. Bit of a smell coming off that rape field. Looking down the valley there to East Beckham, it's about 90 foot here where I'm stood. 90 metres. Gotta get that right. About 180 foot here where I'm stood. There is indeed a footpath here to the left, very overgrown, but I'm not following that. Yeah, I'm going to continue on this track and see what pans out. Now in East Beckham, and what I'm going to do again, having just tested that green lane, which is debatable whether you could get a hybrid up it or not. It's pretty tough going, but this looks better quality surface here, this by road. I have walked up here previously in the winter and it was a quagmire, but if I walk across it now, let's see what happens. If the quality is there, that could certainly shave some minutes off the morning's journey. So, a swallow there. Lovely sight. Bit of local dialect there, sit and mardel, which indeed I will do. Interesting place to be buried. Bob Cockerell. Nice peaceful little green patch. A couple of trees been planted in his memory as well. Next to this little brook. Raising a little weasel, which is the larger of the two, I think, as opposed to a stoat. It's just gone up into that tree, the back of that tree somewhere. There underneath this oak, loads of this white flower again. Lovely. Star flower. This deciduous woodland on my right is Rounce's Coverts on the map, and this by road surface looks okay for a hybrid, so that could save some time. Just notice on the map that some kind of reservoir over there. I think that blue marker indicates Anglian water. Don't know. That church must be in the village of Aylmerton, according to my map. Another classic round towered church that you get in this area, if it is Aylmerton. Looks like this is a GPS site. Geocache, I meant, sorry. Somewhere down here, probably at the base of the tree. Something's hidden. Anyway, there's a reformed cross as marked on the map. Onward journeys straight ahead, I think. So this track is certainly doable, which is good to know. I'm glad I walked it as opposed to the road I was going to walk along. Cuckoo, listen. Such a rare sound these days. Funny enough, I heard one a fortnight ago in Felbrigg, and that is only the second one today that I've heard in 4 years. Incredible. Not sure what purpose this cross serves here in the middle of this junction. There's the old cuckoo again. Hopefully he'll still be singing as I get closer. Must capture that sound. So as you can see, the cycle route that I would be following is 30, which goes all the way to King's Lynn. Joining up with the Weaver's Way here. Cycle route 30 continues on down that way. There's that cuckoo. Wonderful. Such a rare sound now. Incredible. I wonder if it's the same bird, seeing as I'm very close to where I heard it a couple of weeks ago, and they're so scarce. I bet it is. So I continue up here, Park Road. He's calling very regularly and quite loudly. I wonder if that's because he can't actually find a mate. There is that aspect to consider. They're so rare now, it's just unbelievable. Now this is an amazing sight. Right by my feet as I was recording the cuckoo, there appears to be a barn owl. Been attacked by a hawk, clearly. I can't tell if it's alive or dead. Its eyes are wide open. It's a fresh kill. Look at these feathers everywhere. Flies are on it though. So it must be dead. But that's amazing. After seeing that picture in the paper the other day of a hawk taking the owl's vole in mid-flight, an incredible photo that was. The barn owl had caught a vole and it was snatched by a, I think it was a marsh harrier actually, or certainly a harrier of some description. This is unbelievable. Yeah, it's definitely a barn owl, and it is dead. Quite a big bird when you get up close to it. Poor thing. What a lovely setting this is. Rhododendron just about to burst into bloom next to this pond. Fingers crossed, if I get my act together, that'll be in bloom when I get my bike. Passing the old forge and Park Farm here, which is now holiday let by the looks of it. Now walking alongside the wall of Felbrigg Hall, another National Trust property. So two National Trust properties for one today. Another lovely farm building here, built in 1849. And as you'd imagine, swallows are in that barn there. This is on the outskirts of the village known as Aylmerton. Now joining National Cycle Network Route 33, which goes through the park at Felbrigg. The old chiff chaff again. Interesting woodcockery around. Haven't seen those for years. Lapwing are pretty scarce as well. Anyway, this is a gate into Felbrigg, which I won't take today because I'm walking my cycle route. But I often walk in this area. Very nice it is as well. Wonderful park, Felbrigg. You can see at this junction the street and park road. 33 joins up with 30. Here we are. As you can see, Blicklin 10 miles further. Very big property, Blicklin. 33 goes through the grounds, as I said. This is one of the lodges. Holiday rental, no doubt. This little lane ahead of me is called the Lion's Mouth and runs up to the A148. It's a byway to Susted, ultimately. Behind me anyway. That's our onward journey. Sexton's Lodge. This is one of Felbrigg's circular walks. There are a number of them. But the red one is about 5 miles around the estate. Very pleasant it is too. That heads off into what is known as the Great Wood. Lovely copper beech here just coming into leaf. So having started at Sheringham Park, we're now into Felbrigg. There are a number of cattle grids through Felbrigg, which might entail getting off the bike. Yep, livestock. And they are out because I saw them last week. Lovely estate. About 5:15 now, good time to come through. All the crowds have gone, closes at 5, where the cafe does. Wildlife then starts to appear. So, Felbrigg House, and its orangery over there. From the front, I'm not sure if you can see the Latin inscription up there, Gloria in Dio, or Dio in Excelsis. Hang on, where's that bit gone? There it is. Another Humphrey Repton design garden here. It's got its own courtyard cafe over there and garden for produce, walled garden. There's the view from the house. Nice big garden, eh? An old mile post over there. Don't know if you can read it, but it actually says Norwich 20 miles. Gives you some idea where we are. Miles away from anywhere, really. The way I like it. Information panel here about the park. Map there as well. Cycle racks here, all good stuff. There you have it, Cromer Pier, 3 mile. Felbridge Church over there on the right. Not sure if it's still used, but I think it's called St. Margaret's. So there you go. As we depart Felbridge, surface here is pretty good as well. Now on the fringes of Cromer. Not often I get jet noise interference up here, but there is one very rare example. Probably a private plane calling in at Northreps, which is a local airstrip. So 3.25 hours later, 8.5 miles, job done. Very pleasant cycle route, potentially. Obviously, won't take 3.5 hours. Should be done in an hour, but there'll be some tinkering involved. Very pleasant walk, though, all in all. And I'm pleased to say the hip is not too bad either, despite all that hard surface. I'll add the rhododendrons on next week, up at Sheringham Park. Well, here we are. I've had to wait 10 days since finishing the walk to get this vista because the weather's been so bad over half term week. But look at this. I often say nasty things about rhododendron, but when it's kept in order in the appropriate place, it's quite spectacular. Just like the cuckoo's song. Only here for around a month, today being Tuesday, June the 7th. It officially sort of finishes next week. That's when the head gardener stops doing his tours here at Sheringham Park. I'm in one of the viewing towers, which gives this spectacular view. It's It's what Sheringham Park is all about, really. As I say, for a month of the year, it's very busy for these views. A bit like the cherry blossom in Japan, I guess. And as you can hear, wonderful bird song everywhere. Chiff-chaffs, blackbirds, blackcaps. Get all sorts in here. Some pretty rare birds as well. Great place to work for a couple of days a week anyway. Lovely. Peaceful place for repose after a hard day's work. Very popular with dog walkers, this park. Okay, so I think we'll conclude that. Final point here, look, you can see they're already on the wane. These were one of the early bushes out, because I was in this tower previously a couple of weeks ago. Already this one's on its way out. There is said viewing tower. As you can see from the blossoms on the floor, starting to wane already. Seems to depend on the variety. Some of these bushes are just popping out or in peak bloom. This is the walkway back to the tea rooms and the information centre. There's the old van, external seated area, eating area. And over there on the right is the visitor centre cum tea rooms, where yours truly does a bit of work.